Hi everyone. Today in this video, let's talk about diethylpropion. What is this drug diethylpropion? This drug is classified as appetite suppressant. Commonly, this group of drugs which suppress the appetite are known as anorectic drugs. So diethylpropion is an anorectic which suppress the appetite. Along with the control of diet and proper exercise, this drug can be used in the treatment of exogenous obesity, which is simply called as obesity. This is the overweight due to uncontrolled diet and lack of exercise. In such conditions, diethylpropion can be used to treat the obesity in the people with body mass index greater than or equal to 30 kg per square meter. Since this drug is going to reduce appetite, it can reduce the body weight, so that the body mass index can be reduced. But this drug is used for short-term treatment, only for a few weeks this drug can be used, because diethylpropion is one of the sympathomimetic. So this drug can stimulate the sympathetic system, which may stimulate major organs like cardiovascular system, leading to various complications. That's why diethylpropion is not used for long-term treatment. For short-term management of obesity, this drug can be given with few central side effects compared with other drugs within this category. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, what is its chemical nature, what are the important precautions, side effects, dosage forms, and how it should be taken. All these things we will discuss in this video. Now let us see chemical nature of this drug. So this is the simple structure of diethylpropion. Here we can see the ketone group is present, which is attached to the phenyl group. So this drug is also classified chemically as phenone. Now let us give the numbering. We can start the numbering from this ketone group. So this is 1, 2 and 3. So according to the IUPAC, we can give the name as 1-propanone or propane-1-one. Now at the first position, it is having the phenyl group, so 1-phenyl. And at the second position, it is having the amine group, which is further attached with the diethyl groups. So 2-diethylamino. That is the simple name of diethylpropion. So within the chemical name, we can find the name of this drug. Diethylpropion is a diethylaminopropanone derivative. This drug acts like sympathomimetic, and it is somewhat structurally related with the amphetamine. So this drug acts as indirectly acting sympathomimetic. That means even it is not directly acting on the adrenergic receptors, but still it can improve the adrenergic transmission, leading to increased sympathetic activity. Now let us see how this drug acts. Within the CNS, catecholamines play an important role. So norepinephrine is one of the important catecholamine, which is going to be stored into the adrenergic neurons. But the released norepinephrine can be taken back into the nerve terminal by one of the transporter, NET, norepinephrine transporter. This is one of the uptake transporter for the norepinephrine, which reduces the levels of norepinephrine within the synaptic cleft. Now, diethylpropion is one of the drug which can block this norepinephrine transporter, such that it can increase the release of norepinephrine. Similarly, another catecholamine is the dopamine. Again, the dopaminergic neurons are equipped with another uptake transporter, DAT, dopamine transporter. Through this transporter, the dopamine can be again taken into the nerve terminal, which reduces the levels of dopamine after exocytosis. Now again, diethylpropion can block this dopamine transporter, such that dopamine is more released during the exocytosis. In this way, diethylpropion can increase the levels of norepinephrine as well as dopamine within the CNS. Now, when this norepinephrine and dopamine levels are increased within the CNS, they can control the hypothalamus and they can reduce the appetite. So, the hunger centers are inhibited by elevated levels of catecholamines. This is one part of action of diethylpropion, where it can control the appetite by increasing the catecholamine transmission. Similarly, it can act by another mechanism. Within the adipose tissue, lipolysis takes place, by which it can release one of the mediator, leptin, into the bloodstream. These leptin levels can be increased within the circulation, resulting in the inhibitory effect on the one of the peptide, neuropeptide Y. This neuropeptide Y is responsible for neuronal transmission and increasing the hungriness and stimulating the hunger centers. But when this neuropeptide Y is going to be inhibited by leptin, it results in the decreased appetite within the patients. In this way, diethylpropion can reduce the appetite by increasing the transmission of catecholamines, as well as decrease the neuropeptide Y transmission through the elevated levels of leptin. All these mechanisms result in the suppression of appetite. That's why diethylpropion is used as anorectic for the short-term management of obesity. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of diethylpropion is that this drug can act on the sympathetic system, so it can increase the blood pressure. Particularly, this drug can increase the pulmonary hypertension. So this is more important. Within the patients, we can observe increased exercise-induced dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, edema, particularly at the lower extremities, swelling can be observed, syncope, some falling sensation can be observed with this diethylpropion, and even it can increase the symptoms of angina pectoris, resulting in some chest pain, squeezing sensation. All these symptoms can be observed with the diethylpropion because of pulmonary hypertension. Particularly, these symptoms can be observed on long-term treatment with the diethylpropion. That's why this drug should be used for short-term treatment. And within this period, there should be some significant difference in the weight loss. If such significant weight loss is not observed, then this diethylpropion should not be continued. So within first 4 weeks of treatment, at least 4 pounds weight loss should be observed with this diethylpropion. Another important precaution is that with increasing the dose of diethylpropion, we can observe some decreased response. So diethylpropion shows some tolerance towards the weight loss. That's why if significant weight loss is not observed within first 4 weeks of treatment, then the dose of the drug should not be increased as it further increases the tolerance. Instead, it should be discontinued, replacing with an alternative agent. Because as with increasing the dose, tolerance also increases, as well as it can also increase the risk of valvulopathy. The inflammation of cardiac walls are going to be observed, which reduce the cardiac functionality. This valvulopathy is more observed with drugs like fenfluramine, which are withdrawn from the market. Even though diethylpropion is having the less risk for this valvular disorder, but still it should be carefully given at the low dose in order to reduce the cardiovascular complications. Similarly, diethylpropion on prolonged therapy not only increases the side effects, but it also increases the dependence within the patients. So when this drug is suddenly withdrawn, it can produce some withdrawal symptoms. It can also produce some psychotic symptoms such as hallucinations, dyskinesia. Psychotic behavior can be observed with this diethylpropion. Again, because of this reason, diethylpropion is not intended for long-term therapy. So for short-term treatment, less than 4 weeks, this drug can be used for the management of obesity. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of hypertension because this drug is a sympathomimetic. It can increase the sympathetic stimulation, which increase the transmission of adrenergic neurons, leading to elevation in the blood pressure. So this drug may precipitate cardiac arrhythmias. So in the patients with already any cardiac disorders, this drug should be carefully given. Even it can increase the further cardiovascular diseases such as angina pectoris. That's why in the patients with any previous history of cardiac problems, this diethylpropion should be carefully given. And in those patients with severe hypertension, this diethylpropion is contraindicated. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of convulsions. So in the epileptic patients, caution should be taken because this drug can further increase the risk of convulsions. Now let us see the side effects of diethylpropion. The first and important side effect is the elevated blood pressure. So this drug can elevate the blood pressure. Even it can also produce some pulmonary hypertension, resulting in the dyspnea, edema. And it can also increase the palpitations, awareness of heartbeat, tachycardia, increase the heart rate can be observed with this drug. Precordial pain can also be observed because of any pulmonary hypertension. All these are because of increased sympathetic stimulation by this drug, which should be closely monitored. Similarly, this drug can produce few of the central side effects such as nervousness, blurred vision, dizziness, dyskinesia, insomnia, and dry mouth can be observed with this diethylpropion. How it is given? This drug is available as normal tablet, which is an immediate release tablet, available at a strength of 25 mg. So this drug is given as 3 tablets, that is 25 mg given thrice daily. So the total daily dose is 75 mg. And diethylpropion should be given 1 hour before the meal in order to reduce the appetite. So food intake is somewhat reduced in presence of diethylpropion. Even this drug is also available as extended release tablet, which is available at a strength of 75 mg. So this ER tablet is given as 1 tablet per day. So 75 mg extended release tablet is given in the mid morning in order to reduce the appetite, thereby to reduce the food intake. So that's about this drug diethylpropion, which is a sympathomimetic, and this drug is classified as anorectic, appetite suppressant. So this drug can be used in the treatment of obesity, but this drug should be used for short-term treatment as it can increase the sympathetic stimulation leading to various cardiovascular complications. This drug can also develop the tolerance, that's why this drug is intended for short-term treatment. Even it can produce withdrawal symptoms, so sudden stopping of the dose may lead to few of the withdrawal symptoms like hallucinations. But among the anorectics, this drug is having somewhat less central side effects. So this drug can be given as immediate release tablet, which is given thrice daily, or it can be given as extended release tablet, which is given once daily, at least 1 hour before the meal. So that's about this diethylpropion. That's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.